Good afternoon and welcome back to Nasdaq Trade Talks. I'm your host, Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at Nasdaq. We're coming to you live from Rates Evolve, brought to you by Viable Markets, the industry's only global interest rate conference. Joining me for this segment, we have Dan Schleifer. He's the CEO of ChartIQ. Thank you so much for joining us at Rates Evolve. And you are in the sweet spot of capital markets, market technology, and digital transformation. How is it impacting the buy and the sell side?
It's a fun space to be in right now. So I think technology is evolving. I think digital transformation tends to be a little bit of a loaded term. It sounds like this big, kind of lofty thing that sounds unapproachable. But the way that we look at it is it's really about how we can use the modern technology that's been built since the dot-com era to really empower capital markets where they've tended to be based on legacy technologies. And so how we can start to infuse what's been happening in the rest of the world and in the tech space in general into what's driving the markets today.
All right, so, and this is a great time to ask this question. It's the 35th anniversary of the introduction of the Macintosh today, right? And it was funny, it's trending on Twitter as well, and they were asking, what was your first computer? And I'm like, Commodore 64 right here. That's a hashtag old. But, so my question to you is, how is the desktop changing for traders and for brokers?
So mine was a Mac 512K, so I had the second Mac that came out. Again, dating myself.
How is desktop trading?
So, I mean, I think, you know, it's funny because in our consumer lives, we're stuck to our cell phones. And so we think about the web and mobile as being kind of the two major delivery channels. But in capital markets, you walk a trading floor, no one's doing business on an iPad. You know, the web is really not designed for the kinds of use cases that exist in capital markets, and the desktop reigns supreme. And so when we walk a trading floor, we're working with our customers, it's really about how do we let them take advantage of the screen real estate that they have and try to actually make that information actionable, reduce the number of mouse clicks that they need on the desktop, really optimize the desktop experience in a way that I feel like was really ignored while we worried about iOS apps and the mobile experience for millennials.
All right, let's talk about unbundling, another hot topic. Do you think 2019 is the year it actually happens?
I would argue that the unbundling already happened. So when we look at kind of the explosion of fintech, we have best of breed components that do one thing better than everything else. So you no longer need to buy a bundled all-in-one solution. And so much like we've seen happen with the cable networks, I think that's already happened in fintech. The irony is that I think we're actually about to go through a process of rebundling. So much like you now need a Roku device to actually pull together the different channels that you want, so that you don't have to log into different systems to pull together the fintechs that people want, whether it's a legacy fintech, an OMS, and a brand new, you know, startup out of London. We need to actually create the fabric that allows us to glue those applications together in a way that users want.
All right, so fintechs like yourself, ChartIQ, you're disrupting the business. How are traders and brokers, how are they adapting to this?
Yeah, so what's really interesting, we see ourselves as an enabler. And so, you know, while we, again, we try to have disruptive technology, our goal is to enable our customers. We're not competing with Morgan Stanley and JP Morgan. We're trying to make them more efficient. And so, you know, I think you can look in the consumer markets and see how maybe Robinhood is trying to disrupt E-Trade and Fidelity. In our world, especially in capital markets, it's about how can buy side and sell side institutions partner with fintechs and use it as enabling technology to drive their business forward, to become more profitable, to cut costs, et cetera.
All right, it's all about providing solutions, right?
Exactly.
All right, Dan, thank you so much for joining me.
Absolutely, thank you for the time.
Thank you, and thank you for joining me at Rates Evolved. I'm Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at Nasdaq.